So you want to make money bounty hunting. Well, first you no, wait, really. No. Don't do that. Look, you don't understand, but you're wasting your time, your effort, and most likely your money. Here's how the real pros hunt, like me. If you're a new player, most likely your first achievable combat ship that you'll be able to afford is an Eagle. It's a very maneuverable little craft, makes its mark with tight turns and combat orientation. Grab yourself an Eagle. Imperial Eagle is preferable. It doesn't require rank to buy. With a higher turn rate than its progenitor, a bigger power plant to load more goodies onto, and a medium hardpoint on top to complement its two smalls, unlike the regular Eagle Mark II that only has three smalls, you'll be in a good starting shape. You'll need some money, but this should be relatively achievable at around 2 million, with only 100,000 rebuy cost. Trust me, you'll be making this money back pretty fast. The things you want to focus on are your thrusters and your power plant. Max those out, and that means get the highest grade you can for your money's worth. These things are useful. Power plants will let you load more stuff onto your little monster, and better thrusters means better turns and speed. If you can, max out your power distributor also. This helps with overheating and allows you to fire your thermal weapons like lasers longer before they run out of juice. As for the other components, grab yourself the best shield you can and some good hardpoints. My recommendation is that if you can aim, you're using a joystick and you know how to use it well, you're using a controller and you can move well with it, grab two small fixed pulse lasers and a fixed multi-cannon. If you can't aim but you can follow a ship well enough, grab the same but gimbaled. Gimbaled means that these weapons will auto-aim within a reasonable radius in front of your ship. For your utility mount, throw on a kill warrant scanner. This is important. Ship kills that have been scanned correctly with a kill warrant scanner will usually be worth far more than they would be already. Now the rest is up to you, whether you want to beef up your little monster with hull and module reinforcements, add or remove flight assist stuff, have fun with it, test stuff out, try it all out. Here's where the real fun begins. Go to any resource extraction site in your system. They're usually found on planets with rings in populated systems. Best bet is to go to a high resource extraction site if you're feeling brave. Once you're at the resource extraction site, when you jump in, there'll be ships that have joined you and were instanced by the game. Most of the time, you'll find some system security ships as well. They are the key to this. System security is the key. If you see a fight happening, it is most likely between someone wanted and the system security. Find the wanted party in the fight, scan them with your kill warrant scanner. Let the system security do most of the work. Since you're in a less than hardy craft, if you get shot at, do not be afraid to run and re-engage when it's safe. Don't take risks. Let security take the brunt of the force while you pop in and out dealing damage. Elite Dangerous's AI is usually programmed to aim at the highest threat. Since you're new, it shouldn't necessarily prioritize you over the system security, as your rank is most likely somewhere around mostly harmless. That being said, this game has been known to throw a curveball or two. Be on your toes, don't get careless, don't fall asleep at the wheel. Rinse and repeat the cycle until you run out of ammo, run out of hull, maybe you get bored. Then head back to your nearest station and turn in your rewards at the authority contact on station on board. If you want to know my special little place, it's a lovely system called Nanobozo. Lamerick Orbital has almost everything you'll need and is just a stone's throw from a couple resource extraction sites. It has tons of weapons, components, and ships, and I'll usually make a fair amount of money each trip out. If things are looking too calm, supercruise out, and then back in, reinstance it. And remember to scan your targets with a kill warrant scanner. Don't take too many risks, and if you don't want to deal with ammo, stock up on thermal and beam weapons only. You can spend as long out there as you have fuel, hull, and patience for. Hope this helped you all out. I don't actually know how to finish this video. I just realized I don't have an exit. I don't have an outro.